Thanks, Dan. You know, sometimes when you're in the right place at the right time, you get lucky. But today, we're going to talk about that in a different kind of way with a weather phenomenon. Today, I'm diving into the science behind rainbows.
They're seen in folklore and fairy tales, but depending on your location, they can also be seen from your front door. Rainbows are a finicky phenomenon. We're no stranger to rain, but there are certain conditions you need to have to see the spectrum in the sky.
We'll get to that in a second. Let's talk light. Sun gives off white light. Now that white light includes the entire visible spectrum, also known as the rainbow. Remember Roy G. Biv? Yeah. Those colors. Light typically moves at the speed of, well, the speed of light. Now that speed actually changes when light has to travel through a different material, like water. When the white light first hits a raindrop, it bends or refracts. It then bounces or reflects off of the inside of the raindrop before exiting the droplet, separated into the different wavelengths and colors of the rainbow. Remember I said that rainbows are a bit finicky? Well, to see one, you have to be somewhere between the sun and the rain. You also need to have your back to that sunshine so that you can watch out for the not so rare, but sometimes faint, double rainbow. And a viewer requested this week's topic for his granddaughter. So if you or the kiddos in your life have something you want me to explain, you can send me an email or reach out on social media.